Microbiology, the study of microbes. Microorganisms are in the ecosystem associated in multicellular organisms. These colonizations becomes organisms which are eliminated by host defenses. Because there is an infection, because they cause an infection, and therefore because organisms become part of normal flora, which in excess cause illness, or organisms eliminated by host defenses are there because the carrier stayed with no symptoms but with cysts or their excess of existence which are no longer a normal flora has become infectious disease, has become pathogenic. In the clinical microbiology, the final work is to reverse as finding all this kind of pathogenicity to a normal living conditions. That's the reason we study microbiology in the medical field. The infectious diseases are or can be prokaryotic pathogens classified as bacteria, whether eukaryotic organisms such as fungus, protozoa, helminths, and humans. Prokaryotes divide in two major groups, eubacteria, which is bacteria of medical importance, and IPU bacteria are evolutionary distinct organisms. Both of them are different because the structural forms, the shapes are described as rows or spheres or corkscrews. The prokaryotic cells are a little bit smaller than eukaryotic cells, mostly all the bacteria with the exception of mycoplasma have a rigid cell wall, and where the cell membrane is surrounded and determine the shape of the organism. And this wall, the cellular wall, determines how the bacteria is classified as gram positive or gram negative. And the cell wall might be flagella, villi, or capsule, and where the bacteria cells divide in binary fission. Most of the bacteria exchange genetic information which are plasmids who carries it out. And small plasmids, specialized genetic elements are able of cell replication. Also the information necessary to the establish antibiotic resistance. The structure of these bacteria's metabolism and genetics is different of human diseases. It's a wide variety of human diseases caused by bacteria. The atypical bacteria are organisms as mycoplasma, chlamydia, rickettsia, which is also prokaryotic and it's not a, has a lot of very important structural components of metabolic capabilities, and they are separate from a large group of typical bacteria. The fungi are non-photosynthetic, saprophytic, eukaryotic organisms, and some of them have filamentous and are molds, yeast, unicellular, and reproduction might be asexual, sexual, or both, and the fungi produce spores. The fungi, which is pathogenic, cause disease from a skin infection, superficial mycosis, to serious systemic infections as a deep mycosis. The protozoa, single cell, non photosynthetic, eukaryotic organism, presents various shapes and sizes. These are free living, but among others, the most clinically important parasites of humans. Part of this group infect all major tissues. Organism and organs of the body. They can be intracellular parasites, extracellular parasites in the blood, urogenital region, intestine. They are usually transmitted through ingestions of an infective stage or parasite or by insect bite. Protozoa can cause a variety of diseases. Helminths or worms live as parasites, multicellular eukaryotic organisms. Complex body organizations divide in three main groups, the type of worms called cestodes, the flukes, which are trematodes, and roundworms, which are nematodes. Helminths are parasitic, which nurtures from the ingested and absorbed digestive contents. Ingested and absorbing fluids or tissues. Any organ in the human body can be parasitized. Viruses are obligated intracellular parasites. and do not have cellular structure, and as a molecule of DNA or RNA, but not both. And it has only a protein coat which surrounds it. It has an envelope derived from plasma membrane of host cell where the virus is released, contain genetic information for directing their own replication, requires host cellular structures and enzymes machinery to complete process of their own reproduction. Following viral infections from lysis, which can occur in a rapid way, releasing many progeny variants to gradual prolonged release of our particles. And they can cause a lot of diseases. The microorganisms have organization. Because the names do characteristics of pathogenic organisms. And they organize into logical groups, adding, which helps relating, and that way can be visualized using a color-coded system to the end. Some of the authors of several books use this system to allow to identify as the work is done in laboratories, in some of the laboratories, and therefore, because the way it's been done, they have a hierarchical organization. And this is a resemble of family tree, where the major characteristics of particular microorganisms shows up. For example, the staphylococci, they show they have rigid cell and a simple unicellular free living organisms that are gram-positive cocci. And then they have another chart organization with the bacteria and viruses, and represents selected groups of bacteria or viruses at which is on a pie chart. And therefore, you can be able to find the pie charts, which is more like showing the important definition in regards to characteristics of particular organism. How the bacteria are organized in eight groups according to gram staining, morphology, and biochemical and other characteristics. Then the ninth section of bacteria pie chart is labeled other, to represent organisms not included in one or other of the eight categories. Take a look in your books how the distribution of these bodies into the microbiology is being done, and see if it's just a line or if it's a chart with a pie segment. And this is like we were saying, the way this is organized by groups according to the pathogenesis. The end reaction to the testings. the taxonomy uses a hierarchy for the classification of bacteria, fungi, protozoas, and helminths. The kingdoms are divided into evolutionary, such as phylae, classes, orders, families, genera, species. The first letter of the genus name is always capitalized, and the species name begins with a lowercase letter. Both names are printed in italics. Take a look up there, and the charts that they are offered by your book and your book. We have the electron microscope and the microorganisms that you can see through it. It's going to be viruses, proteins, prions, and small molecules. Under the light microscope, you will be able to see the large protozoa, the eukaryotic cells, the most bacteria, and the mitochondria. On the unaided eye, you will be able to see the worms. The classification of medically important bacteria families are that under the gram-positive, we have the cocci and the rods. Under the gram-negative, we have the cocci, the non-enteric rods, and the enteric rods. Under the simple unicellular, we have the obligate intracellular parasites and the free living. Under the rigid cells, we have the filamentous and the simple unicellular. And under the medically important bacteria, which is everything, we have the distribution of all of them, including the lacking of cell walls and the flexible spirochetes. And the classification of important medically virus families are that enveloped is the icosahedral and the helical. Under the positive strand, we have the envelope, which we mentioned, and the non-envelope, the icosahedral. And then on the positive strand, which we mentioned, we also have, on the other hand, a negative strand helical envelope, which belongs to single-stranded. And this single-stranded, along with the double-stranded icosahedral, not envelope, belongs to the RNA. And separated, the non-envelope and the enveloped belong to double-stranded, just right beside single-stranded and non-enveloped belong both. All the four to the DNA. And the RNA and the DNA virus families belong to the medically important viruses. Take a look at the distribution of all the important issues that there are in regards of the chart you have from the ones that I have already mentioned. Introducing or getting into normal flora, we're saying that the human body has inhabitants. And this is by many different microorganisms, mostly bacteria. And something that is there all the time is the fungi and other microorganisms, which under normal circumstances, they are harmless. And perhaps beneficial. There are called normal flora, and this which literally means organisms that dine together, and with exception of transients, invaders, the organs of the human body and systems are sterile, and the spleen, the pancreas, the liver, the bladder, the central nervous system, and the blood. A healthy newborn enters the world in essentially sterile conditions. And it's been said that after is born, occurs flora, which becomes normal in his or her body from the food of the environment which the human is already included. It says over here, right, if you take a look at your books also, that the species there are in normal flora are not rigidly defined for all humans. Because they vary from people to people, because of physiologic differences. Diet, age, geographic habitat. And must notice the normal types and distributions of the flora, because this will allow you to understand whatever happens if a patient has an infection resulting from injuries in their body, because the site, places, and possibly sources of microorganisms isolated in some part in the human body cause an infection. The skin, which is something that we have to take a look very closely, can be a cure bacteria right away from the environment, but this is transient flora which dies, but it also can be removable by washing skin surfaces. It's not a place where, or environment when it can be colonized by microorganisms. It's dry most of the time, conductive to bacterial growth, that dry usually very often. It's slightly acidic. Their pH is acidic. And the sweat glands has high concentration of sodium chloride, which becomes hyperosmotic. The environment or the surface of the skin. And it supports bacteria population And some writers of microbiology books call them resident flora, which they can be found in multiple layers in the skin, which they regenerate after vigorous scrubbing. They are aerobic staphylococcus epidermids. Coagulase negative staphylococcus, and which they result in the outer layer of the skin, and 90% of the skin aerobes. Anaerobic organisms such as Propionibacterium acnes are found deeper in the skin layers, hair follicles, sweat, and sebaceous glands, and are harmless. The S. epidermidis can be residing and colonized because the plastic catheters and medical devices which penetrate skin where the bloodstreams becomes seriously infected. Conjunctiva of the eye is colonized by S. epidermidis medis and Staphylococcus aureus, aerobic corinne bacteria, Streptococcus pneumoniae. They normally live in the human body. Other than those are present, but they're not there for a long time. Tears, which contain the antimicrobial enzyme lysosome, helps eliminating bacterial population of the conjunctiva. The mouth and nose also have a tendency to harbor microorganisms, aerobic and anaerobic. One of the commonest diphtheria corynebacterium species, which is the same, the S. aureus, the S. epidermidis. And also the teeth and surrounding gingival tissue, and you can find the streptococci mutants. The mutants can enter the bloodstream through dental surgery and colonize damage after prosthetic hair valves, producing endocarditis. The nasopharynx can cause disease. These bacteria in there can cause disease, and you can find the S. pneumoniae, and is found even in people with has a standard normal healthy living, can cause an acute bacteria pneumonia after a certain age, when the bacteria has certain disease and is resistant and provides some resistance. This pneumonia is usually found in the upper or middle respiratory viral infection, which eventually becomes S. pneumoniae. infecting the pulmonary parenchyma. And the intestinal drought, usually in the adults, the density of this in the stomach is low. The gastric enzymes and acidic pH is the reason. The density of certain organisms increase. The alimentary canal, where the contents in the ileum and the large intestine and therefore over there are there where they live. It's 20% of the fecal mass contains different species of bacteria. More or less 90% are anaerobes, bacterial species constitute a big percentage of bacteria in the large intestine. The urogenital tract, its low pH of adult vagina is to the presence of lactobacillus species, which is component of normal flora. The lactobacillus population there is decreased. By antibiotic therapies, and it raises, the pH raises, and potential pathogens also can overgrow. The reason of this overgrow is the yeast life fungus, Candida albicans, itself is a minor member of the vagina normal flora, mouth, and small intestine. The urine and the kidney bladder are sterile. Somehow can get contaminated in the lower urethra by this organism we are mentioning, because they live on the outer layer of the skin and perineum. The benefits, functionings of normal flora provide benefits to host digit number harmless bacteria, lower bowel mouth, and healthy people. Where invading pathogen is not going to compete for nutrients and receptor sites, because bacteria of bowel is antimicrobial substances producers themselves and are immune, and bacterial colonization of a newborn infant is acting as a certain powerful stimulus to develop the immune system. And the bacteria of the gut provide nutrients, vitamins, K, and helps digestion and absorption of nutrients. Take a look at your book, how the bacteria inhabits the gastrointestinal tract, the gram-positive cocci, Staphylococcus species, Staphylococcus viridans, Enterococcus species, and the gram-negative rhodes, Enterobacter species, is Escherichia coli, Klebsiella species, Proteus species, Pseudomonas species, and the anaerobic organisms, which is bacteroid species, Clostridium species, Lactobacillus species, where the bacteriotes fragilis causes intra-abdominal abscesses, and additional intestinal bacteria commonly cause peritonitis following appendicitis, diverticulitis, and other trauma resulting in perforation of intestines. And other causes are actinomyces species. The harmful effects of normal flora, which is seen as a problems or clinical problems. When the flora arises on certain conditions, and decide when organisms are displaced from their normal site in the body, is when some other normal bacteria is introduced, such as S. epidermidis, in the bloodstream. And then they colonize and caused by catheters or hard balls, resulting in bacterial endocarditis. And another thing is the how the pathogens grow is by gaining competitive advantage. When some other population diminished, and when it's depleted by antibiotic therapies, which is overgrowing some resistance deficit, causing severe colitis. And another hand, when the harmless are usually ingested, pasta food substances turning into carcinogenic derivatives by bacteria in the colon. And these examples converts by bacterial sulfatases or the sweetener cycla made into bladder carcinogen cyclohexamine. And then and another thing is when the individuals become immunocompromised and overgrowing flora, which is supposed to be normal, become pathogenic, is should be distinguished from carrier stage and where the pathogen that is supposed to live called through pathogen is carried by a healthy asymptomatic individual were to pass to other individual, resulting in disease como typhoid, fever, example of disease that can be acquired from a carrier or other person.